Good morning, everybody, and welcome to vlog. Ooh, that's a thing. Number four. I don't remember how many vlogs I'm on. It is 8 o'clock in the morning, and for once in the British Isles, it is actually warm. I'm wearing no sleeves at 8 in the morning. This is amazing for our kind of weather. We're used to getting up and it being overcast and cold and ugh. So the reason I'm up at 8 in the morning on my own having a walk is I'm gonna go visit my buddy Seb today, and I thought I'd film it because we normally get up to really odd geeky things and I thought we'd have to actually catch it on camera. I'm knackered already and house is just down there. Oh god. I had a long shift yesterday. I didn't finish work till 10 in the evening because we had a fashion show evening going on. And then just as I was settling down in bed, really nice and comfortable, the mosquito right past my ear. It took me 10 minutes to try and find it, and then I didn't hit it. So it lived. And I just had to wait for it to land and just shut up before I could go to sleep. I just kind of put a pillow over my head. I'm not built for exercise in the morning. I'm not built for exercise at any point in the day. I'm built for cuddles and food and video games and movies. That's what I'm built for. A lot of people in cars probably think I'm weird because I'm vlogging to a camera down a main road. Because you don't normally get this kind of stuff in this country, especially not this town. I'm being stared at by the drivers. I guess people in America may be more used to it because a lot of YouTube vloggers come from America. But yeah, my arm's getting tired and I better speed up so I don't miss the train. But it's a long journey, and if I miss it, then it's a while before the other one comes. So I'll see you guys a bit later.
I ended up missing the first train, but I managed to get another one, so I'm currently waiting in Marylebone with Cornish pasty and people behind me are probably staring at me as I'm vlogging. I don't normally vlog when other people are about places like this, but I thought I would because I've got nothing else to do until the train arrives. But I've eaten my pasty, which is really, really hot, waiting for it to cool down. And that is the best part of London stations, is there's normally a Cornish pasty stand, but I love Cornish pasties.
So yeah,
let's wait for the train to arrive, and then I'll be off again.
Better make it a good one then.
What? I know you're filming. Because that's what that bing was.
Yeah, hello.
Goodbye.
There's a gap there now, Seb. Oh. I can see the Nerf gun box, you've given it away. Sebastian! Taking cover. Behind the chair.
Yeah.
Seb is literally the worst at surprise entrances.
I don't need those clumsy weapons anyway. Whoops, broke my own door just then.
Shit, I'm unarmed.
Oh, whose fault is that? This would look really cool in the dark if the lights were out and it was night time. That'd look pretty cool.
In the face. I have the force. I never knew I did that.
This thing, what? It's making the wave around noises and it's not even moving.
You really do walk like you're absolutely pished.
Maybe he is.
Yeah, well, he is a big blue ball. Maybe he's just like blue vodka. He's a blue jello shot. Is what he is.
So what should we go for today?
Pizza.
Yeah, what? Ah, go for that one.
It's different.
Search the roars in which monsters speak to one doctor, two unique.
And so basically, which sound is correct that the monster makes and what sound is wrong?
Oh, to Quark Chamber. I love quarks. I wanted to build one and I never got around to it.
There's still time.
I wanted to turn it into a cupboard So I could just use the quark as a storage space.
Pretty dangerous storage space, really.
Yeah, train the quark to, you know, obey my commands.
I think the Dominators would be very happy with that arrangement.
Oh, I'm sure I can sort of... Quark! Look, they're so adorable. They look like they belong in Star Wars. And they do sound like they're saying no offence, so they do sound polite.
They don't mean to do what they do, they're just told to do it.
No offence. Honestly, no offence.
I can hear the power rod going off. Somewhere.
I didn't even know it made a sound. I'm sorry, what was the sound it makes?
Oh, come on!
You just get stuck on the doorways.
I'm too big.
Too fat. Like a full door. You fat amorphous blue blob.
I take offence. Oh, move!
The clock's down.
Move! Oh, there he is. I know I'd be here.
You weren't going mad. Not much, anyway.
I need to get in the lift. But it's right behind me. Jolly right. Let's do it.
It's rock and roll, son.
I told you never to trust the master.
Never said I trusted the master. It just
still doing... sounds good, though, did the second Doctor mention the master?
Oh, yeah.
Stones, Grok, time for a challenge. All you have to do is tell truly from false. Simple, really.
Yeah, not when you're involved. That's a Yeti.
It is, but I think there was a glitch in this game, because if you go false, it won't accept it, because the Quarks and the Yeti have somehow... I'll go false, because it is false,
oh,
but I guarantee you it's going to deduct life.
Oh.
Maybe it's because there weren't enough noises to warrant one the Quarks. Well, that's Silurians.
Yeah.
That's definitely false. That's definitely false. That's false. I think that's Zygons.
I don't recognise that noise.
I think that was Zygons, that last one.
Well, come into my domain. You'll be singing a very different tune before long.
Tune.
We'll see.
We shall see.
Chaos on the underground with the Yetis.
Shame there were no Yetis when I was travelling here today. Oh, I love this cutscene.
Your train follows my platform, one gap. Indefinite delays expected, Gub.
I would just poop myself if I went up to the ticket booth and Antonelli was sitting there like, what train are you getting this morning, love? London Victoria, please. All right, dear. There's got to be some delays from Eastbourne, is that right?
Is that all right?
Yes, sir.
Exciting. Do we need tickets?
And yeah, this is what driving a train is like in real life.
What? Pressing forward. Jumping.
You can just jump over the tracks just like that. Move!
Oh.
I'll have you melt it down and recycled. Be off! No, excellent work.
We won a Troughton.
Thank you so very much.
Oh, this is where me and Helen get our sexy master pole dancing quote thing from. Because he kind of tries to fall over, but it looks like he's pole dancing.
If you put the
he does that. Da 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 da. All the way through, like, the last couple of years at school. Oh, was it? No, it was college. We were just getting sexy master pole dancing. And it was a reference to that clip.
I can just imagine how someone's got to have put a video together where it's just that clip and just that bit goes round and back, round and back to music.
Ooh, it's ooh, ooh. Yeah, I'd take him to the pub.
I'm sure you would. Right, where are we going now?
What was that tone for? Just mash and then, like, close your eyes and mash and then open them again. We're going for Pertwee!
Up Hadley.
Oh yes.
Excellent. And they had to, and they used, because unfortunately he died before they made this game, like literally right before. So that's why they don't have a voice impersonator like they do for 1 and 2. Because they asked his wife if it'd be okay if they used voice clips from the series. And she said yeah, so that's why he's the only one who's actually got voice clips from the show. As opposed to an impersonator or new dialogue.
I find it weird how in the original series the nesting consciousness is an octopus, and in the new one it's a big ball of lava.
Yeah. I suppose because it's a formless entity, or supposedly, so I suppose it can just take on whatever form it wants. Maybe it likes octopuses.
I'd be like a giant freaking dragon, so I'd just be like, stop. You can form anything. I wouldn't form something that has to stay in a vat. To be quite honest, I got the short end of the stick. Click.
We lost it then.
Such roars in which monsters speak to one doctor, two unique.
Oh, you got the same challenge.
Yes. Research noises.
Hello.
Yes. Aaliyah is now playing Destiny of the Doctors, and she's on the way to rescuing the first Doctor. We've only got the first, the fifth, and the fourth left to do.
We're leaving Tom Baker's to last, and it's the hardest.
Yeah, although, actually, Hartnell's challenge is quite difficult as well, to be honest.
Oh dear. But their legs look really stumpy. No.
Well, it's okay, we've got plenty of health, so...
That's alright, because I'm probably going to use it all trying to find out where the hell I'm going. Shut up. I'm going this door.
Doesn't this lead back to the console room?
Yes. The TARDIS is a big place, okay?
I'll let you off.
Oh,
but they won't.
Bob and weave.
Oh.
Total destruction.
Nice. Take the door on your left.
Take the door on my left. This one.
Ooh. That's the one.
That's the one. Oh, you're still filming this.
Still filming, yes. Definitely have to film the challenge when that comes. It's the Celestial Toy Maker. It's one of his toys. You end up inside.
Oh, yeah, you end up in the little thingy box thing.
That door's locked!
Oh, God. Oh, yeah. I haven't played this in ages, and when I did, it was literally for 5 minutes.
No excuses.
There you go. This game has horrible controls, and bad textures, and bad mapping, and there's nothing there. They're behind me and in front of me.
But it provides hours of entertainment.
It does, because it's one of those it's so bad it's good kind of things.
Yeah.
Yes, there we go.
For me, it's mainly nostalgia based.
Yeah, it's some awful, awful games that torch nostalgia. But I want to get the Zoo Tycoon 2 back, because I remember playing that a lot when I was younger. But I can't find a copy of it, and it's actually quite hard to get online as well. Which one should we do?
What are we going for?
I'll go for the ones with the things that look different.
Oh, yes.
Oh.
Yeah, we've not had one of them yet.
Let's see if I remember the challenge.
Master's forgot it.
Oh, what a ghastly sight. Look, not just one doctor, but three. Intrigued, Grok?
Yes. Well
then, come see for yourself.
You've got to find out which doctor out of the three of them is the real first doctor.
I barely watched the first doctor, I will admit.
Well, this will be fun, won't you? Yeah, so you know how I was mentioning earlier that we were on our way to rescue the first doctor? Aaliyah has somehow managed to get Grok stuck, and there is no way out. We're in the TARDIS swimming pool when we're stuck on some kind of on the staircase.
Oh. Da, 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 da. I'm stuck in a pool.
We have a couple of quarks trying to get us.
Can you shoot up? Shoot up, or you might knock me out.
I think that's it. Well, what do you have to say for yourself?
I'm sorry I let you down, Doctor. I know I've truly been a bad guy at heart, but I wanted to save you. I wanted to do good, man. For once, I wanted to do good.
Oh. Just look at him go. Oh, it's first person shooter and shit. Just like GoldenEye.
Bugger, how are you acting?
How do you know not to do a lightsaber?
Hey, my lightsaber's got different buttons.
This one will. I fired two!
Misfire, misfire! Oh. Oh, right in the neck!
Oh, dead shot me! About it, mate, it's the person using it. You got the skills, got the style, you got the flair.
Whoops. No one did that like that.
I tried the stormtroopers a thing or two about how to hit targets. Whoa, no!
I think that one's worked. No. Oh, we're getting jammed.
Oh, it's nearly coming out, I can see it. It's there! It's actually out. It's like a poo that just won't come out.
I've got a problem with my guns, officer. It's like a poo.
And this is why the Empire constantly fail.
It's your weaponry! It's not mine. I blame the manufacturer. Or the person supplying the weapons. See, this is typical rebellion stuff. This is why we don't take theirs, we keep our E11s.
What about Ewoks and stones and logs?
We don't talk about that.
We all know what happened on Endor. Don't fall! Ah! She's gone mad.
Gone blind, trying to fix your
with power. Right. I might have sabotaged it. Goodbye. Yes, because I know you try and use it. So here we are. Can you see anything? Yes. It's a little bit dark, but she doesn't know that we're in here. So if we keep it quiet, she'll never know. And then we can get a surprise attack sorted out. Now, we're going to improvise a little bit because there aren't too many weapons out here that we can actually use. So it's going to have to be very improvised and very sort of, you know, improvised. That's all I can think of. Now, if you look outside... Ah! Oh, I can see the nozzle! Please, I have children and they...
Oh, the Empire!
Oh, what's happened to me? My arm!
Surrender, rebel scum!
Okay, fine, I surrender. Just put the gun down and everybody's happy. Okay.
Put your weapon down.
It's down.
Weapons down!
It's down, man!
Hands up! Move out! Keep your hands where I can see them.
Well, I've got to get up, and I'm holding the camera.
Keep your hands where I can see them.
I can't get out. Oh, my word. See, I'm out.
Don't take no prisoners. Bullets.
See that, how useless? Oh, I've run out of bullets.
Yeah, this is what you do in the middle of the war. You just go, wait, reload.
Pause, ceasefire, I need to reload.
Let me get all my squidgy bits back.
Right in the bottle cap. Oh! Yes, look at that. Bottle caps.
the classic.
Yeah, so Leah is all ready for the apocalypse when it comes.
Indeed, I am.
Accidentally zoomed into your crotch then. I tried to zoom out.
I'm so ready for the apocalypse.
Accidentally zoomed in.
Well, you know, camouflage.
Oh,
my crotch is camouflage. Just in case.
Right.
Oh, that smells as well.
Gotcha!
Oh.
We're under attack. This is an urgent message going out to the rebellion. We're under attack. I'm pinned down. The Empire, they've just come and... Wait a minute, I've got a shield! I've got a shield! Oh, that's just above my head. Oh. I don't know if you can see this. But... I don't know how I've survived this.
You're lucky the gun's jammed again.
I'm actually hiding underneath the remains of an airbed, and it seems to work quite nicely because all the bullets, they've rebounded off the wall and they've gone straight behind me. So, doing all right for now.
Oh, I found the problem. I've only got one left.
Well, you better make the most of it.
I'm going to find the ones I shot at you in the cupboard.
Oh... Please, God, send assistance. Send the Rogue Squadron in.
That really didn't work.
No, it didn't. I tried to throw a bullet back and it didn't work at all. But they're regrouping. And actually, I'm going to take this opportunity to emerge from hiding and make a retreat. I'm going to flee and I'm going to go to somewhere where she won't find me. Because I'm quite good at hide and seek, as Aaliyah would tell you.
He is actually.
I hid inside this wardrobe, she opened the doors and she still couldn't see me. Mwah! Anyway, time to fly! Time to get out of here.
What?
Oh, I thought that was going to be the beginning of an epic chase. But the gun got jammed. Jammed again!
Stupid rebellion weaponry.
Yes, because the Empire weapons always hit their targets, don't they?
We let the rebels go in the Death Star so we could find out where the base was. So we had to miss.
But what logic was that? You still got blown up because of that.
Yes, but we were going to blow them up first.
But you didn't quite get there in time, did you?
Not quite.
As you can see, we are in the midst of fixing the gun.
What time now?
I've lost count. So the Nerf Retaliator looks good on the box, but it is prone to getting jammed. So if you're going to take part in a Nerf War and you want any chance of survival, I suggest you do not get this. Even though it looks cool, I do not suggest getting
it. It's also taking out chunks of the darts. I think that's why they're getting stuck.
Error.
So to those who want to buy a Nerf Retaliator, you want... You said no, I won't buy it when I get a Nerf gun. Because every time I come around your house, I'm just like, I really need a Nerf gun. You make me into even worse of a compulsive liar than I already am.
Excuse me, I will not be held accountable for that.
Yes, you should. I think I got it working.
The thing is, I've got an excellent hiding place here because no one knows where it is and it's fully shielded. Well, I say it's fully shielded. I mean, it is like from certain firearms, but I'm not sure how well it will do against Imperial firepower. But if I'm just lost out, I haven't got any food supplies or water or anything, so I don't know how long I'm going to have to last out. It could be a while. So I'm keeping this video diary because I might die, and then I want people to watch it back so they can say, "Oh my God, he survived!" If I do survive, or, oh my God, that was him who died, didn't it? And then I can just be like, yeah, those are my video diaries. So this is day one in the shield. It's all right. Getting a little bit warm. But so far, still alive.
Later.
Yeah, the temperature is rising now. But then again, war is uncomfortable. I was trained for this. Now it's time to put all my training into practice. And I know she's creeping about. She thinks she's being all stealthy and quiet, but she ain't.
2 hours later.
Reminds me of the Willow Witch Project. Oh, how old school is that? It's almost like, Wada! And all the rest of that. That was a good advert. Why don't they make him like that anymore? I hear movement. There's something outside. This make a good horror movie, actually. Close up of the eye. There's something outside.
6 hours later.
So we're gonna have to stay the night. But Grandpa, I can't sleep in there. Well, you're gonna have to, Bobby. We ain't got no choice. Maybe I should just get up with the duvet on. Then I'd be definitely protected. Yes, a marvellous idea. Oh, she's not over there. Oh, my leg. Oh dear. Oh, I there. Oh, shit. She's hiding somewhere. I know she is.
Oh, ah, I felt something. Hello, is that you or was that the chair? Oh, whatever it was, let's move. Let's see how far I get. Well, I'm at the door. Ow. I think I'm not gonna fall down the stairs going this way. So.
You don't know how hard it was to stand there and not. I was literally right by the bed the whole time. I was just doing that and waiting for you to move and trying not to laugh.
See, now I had a feeling that you were there.
Yeah, I put my necklace inside my shirt because when I moved it jiggled and I was like. Just stood there like that for like 5 minutes. Talking about the Blair Witch Project and someone going for a barbecue.
Yes. Well, no doubt you'll get to see the whole story later on when you when you look back at it.
My bed. I'm running.
On top of
the stairs. No guards. Yes, I can. I can see you there. Here we go. Makeshift shield. It's Captain America style.
Ah! In the leg.
Trying to be stealthy. You walked right past me at one point, it's hilarious.
When?
I was hiding in your room.
Dead? I think, buddy, you is the one who is dead. Eat, fat man!
Just to recap, Seb just used a mini nuke to blow up one guy.
Because I'm hardcore, baby!
Hardcore overkill, either one you might choose.
Oh, and there's cars! This is gonna be amazing! Oh, did you really want to do that? Did you really? Well.
Oh, that blew up good. Oh. And an extra bit on the side. You wasted your new Coca-Cola Quantum by drinking it.
Ooh!
Ooh, Red Scorpion.
I hate those things.
Oh, the noise they make. Oh, it gives me the shivers. I don't like bugs.
Especially the albino ones. They are massive and very hard to kill.
I haven't come across one of those, actually.
Oh, they're horrible. You don't want to.
Oh, I remember this town, though.
And oh, Dale. Isn't this where the cannibals live?
I don't know.
Like, you break into their shed in the back garden, and then you steal the human flesh in there, and then they will hate you for it, and they try and kill you.
I just remember a town similar to this had a lot of ants in it. The big fire ants.
Oh, that's Greyditch.
Oh, Greyditch.
This, I'm sure this is... Yeah, because this is the... Yeah.
Ah.
They're all cannibals that live here.
I upped my lockpick to 100 as soon as possible, just so I could break into Berg's house. And I stole his hat and sunglasses.
Old man Harris, he's the only one who knows that they're cannibals.
And yet he lives there?
Well, he's an old man, he ain't got no place to go.
I'd be like, screw it, I'll go sleep in a ditch.
The Wilsons.
What a nice name, and yet they're...
They sound like such a well-off family. Hello.
Someone here coming. How can our little family help you?
Show me where you hid the bodies.
Are you joking?
But.
Ah!
And I'll shoot you. Yes, I can.
Can undo. Goodbye. We're gonna uncover your deadly secret.
You cannibal bastards.
What? I've got the key!
I've got
the key!
You definitely picked the key up. Come on, Belle, don't hide from me now. I got a nuclear weapon and you don't want none of this.
Don't do this to me, Belle!
Oh, you'll just have to kill him.
It's already caught. Oh, I'll have to kill him then.
Stab him in the back.
Power fist. Oh, is that like the power glove?
Just
oh,
as he turns around.
He looks so sad. Ow. Ow.
There.
Oh, now you got it. Yes, your husband's just having a nap.
He's been put to sleep.
Pay no attention to the dead body upstairs. Pay no attention to the dead body upstairs.
What's been going on in here? Huh.
All the dead bodies.
Ripper.
Strange meat.
Yes, we all know what that is.
Oh, I don't know if you're going to eat that.
Take some for analysis.
The wonders of Fallout. Beautiful game, so well crafted, so dark.
Oh my god! You want it, bitch? You want it, huh? Huh? Eat this!
Ooh! It's raining people, hallelujah, it's raining people. And it's now irradiated.
It's so totally worth it.
The power lines of death you can hear buzzing.
I always hate walking under these. Because it's just that thought that lingers.
Oh yeah, because they're so loud.
It's like, what if it comes down now?
You just have to make a run for it, but then if electricity does jump...
It'd be pretty instant though, wouldn't it? Just be like,
yeah,
touch
you wouldn't feel any pain, you just die.
It'd be quite a spectacle for anyone who was watching. They'd just peer out the window, what's going on today?
Oh, there's a smoking corpse that's just currently in the thing.
Can the bodies be a case of it? Just close the curtains, get back to what I was doing.
Yeah.
La 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 la. So yes, we're having a rather marvellous walk towards the train station.
Yes. Because I've got to go home, because it takes forever to travel back home.
That's the problem.
It's only 6 o'clock. I'd normally stay till like 8, but it's a long journey.
Was it 2 or 3 hours it takes now?
Yeah, about 3 hours.
It takes an hour from Aylesbury into London. Whichever way you go, because you can go via Wickham as well.
Mm.
But that's slightly longer if you get that one.
No, I just went straight from Marylebone to here. It's the wait because I've got a long wait at London Bridge to get a train back to my station, but I'm probably going to get one at Hayward Teeth and then pop off and get some noms.
Nom!
It! There's a police officer over there.
Oh dear.
It's not me, it wasn't me, not at all. Oh, my hairspray's completely failed. The hair is just gone. It doesn't help probably all the rolling around on the floor trying to shoot guns at each other.
Well, yeah.
Yeah.
But, you know, that was fun.
That was fun. I look forward to watching the footage back.
There's a load of nonsense I recorded on there when I was hiding away.
Yes, no, because I was standing by the bed when you were doing it, thinking, do I jump on him or do I wait and try and make him jump? It's those tough decisions we have to make in life.
Very tough.
Very tough.
It's tough at the top.
Everybody stares when you're vlogging.
I know. It's like, oh my god. People. Camera. What are they doing?
You don't watch YouTube or whatever. It's like normal, isn't it? Well, it's more normal. I was saying it's more normal in America than it is here.
Yeah.
All the vloggers are American.
Every other person walking down the streets vlogging something.
God, it's really dark on camera, or that might just be my eyesight.
It does look pretty dark. You probably watch it back and it'll be fine.
Yeah.
You'll be like, what the hell am I talking about?
Be like, oh, I don't know, I talk about all kinds of things. Alright, so when are we going to do this again?
Soon. Very soon, hopefully.
Very soon.
Whenever. You're next free.
We're next available. Because it's normally it's a 6 month gap when we actually get to see each other.
We have to try and make it a bit shorter. Well, not a bit, a lot.
Maybe like try for 3 months, maybe. 3 month gap. See how that works. That looks awful.
We've spent 3,000 quid doing that up. What have you done to it?
Yeah, what he's done is put green rims on it and a big exhaust. So it just sounds like Shrek's farts. And looks like Shrek. Ew! I'm sorry, I do classic cars, I don't do this newfangled nonsense.
Yes, like the Mini that you've got.
Yes, which is not always reliable.
But it's cool.
Yeah, of course it is. It's a Mini Cooper. People I know probably sick of hearing me talk about my Mini, but I love it. If you're sick of hearing me talk about my car, find me something that I love more than my car. And not Star Wars, because that's just a given. I talk about Star Wars, Spider-Man, and my car. That's the three things. Doctor Who is falling out of love a little bit. Oh my god, choppers. Look at that one!
There you go.
Oh, that noise. Oh.
See, I think we found something now.
Oh, I grew up with motorbikes, that's why. Proper Harley Davidsons. That got that guttural. Ugh.
Can you smell like barbecue sort of smell as well?
Don't. Getting worse. I got food in my bag because I was like, I'm probably going to have to leave before food, so bring food. It's the joys of travel.
Yeah. Well, next time we'll make sure, I mean, whether I come to you or you come to me, whatever way we're working it out, we'll do it so that we both got a couple of days off.
Yes.
And then, because if we're going to be travelling this distance, you're going to need...
We're going to need to start staying over.
Yes. And then
you
could turn the lights out and do Alien Isolation. In the dark.
No, we're not playing Alien Isolation.
Put it on hardcore, man.
No, because you'll be playing it and I'll be sitting in the corner screaming.
Oh no, I'm going to hand the control to you. There you go.
No.
Off you go. Nah, it's alright though.
No scary horror games around my house. Also, you have Xbox games and I'm a PlayStation girl.
Am too. I got a PS2 and I got that little PS1 that you saw.
Yes, so, true, but you don't have any more, do you?
I have been considering getting a PS4. Considering.
Considering.
Depends what goes on with the new releases.
Mm,
if
well,
they come back out on the 360, then yes.
I just want Fallout 4 and the new Battlefront, but I'm going to wait. I'm going to not pre-order the new Battlefront or do anything with it.
I forgot to ask you about that. So, I saw the footage they released. Like, ooh, this looks good.
The gameplay footage looks pretty good, actually.
But it just depends if it's actually going to end up being like that.
That's the thing. Gameplay footage can be changed. It can be like super polished, then you get the game, and it's just.
Want to make it to look brand spanking fantastic at the E3 event.
Yep.
Where they know all the interest is going to be.
It's just publicity is what it is, which sucks. So I'm going to probably just wait for it to be a bit cheaper, which is what I normally do with big games. I'm like, apart from like ones that I know are good, like Grand Theft Auto, because I know that was good. So I just don't trust EA. Okay? They've let me down, man. EA have let me down.
Hopefully they'll make up for that.
They bloody
When's
better.
It supposed to be coming out? At the end of the year?
Yeah, it's supposed to coincide with the movie.
Ooh!
So that'll be interesting. Excellent. I just want to see the movie. I know I'm going to cry when I'm in the cinema. When
it won't take long. It'll just be, as soon as the music starts, that'll be new.
As soon as you get the... George, you might get the 20th Century Fox bit at the beginning, because you get that, and then you get the logo, then you get Long Time Ago, then you get that. You won't get that anymore. So you just have to wait for the
Well, that's what the I don't know if you've seen the Star Wars in concert videos, but they even have the 20th Century Fox thing at the start of that as
they
well.
They have it on the soundtrack. This is a part of Star Wars, and it's a shame it's not going to be that anymore.
I always get depressed now when if there's a film on TV, I haven't seen what it is, and I see that start, I think, yes,
Star Wars. It's the plight of many a fan. Is 20th Century Fox. Yes. Damn it.
God damn!
I just want to see that Chrome Stormtrooper in action, Captain Phasma, who is a female Stormtrooper.
Yeah.
Finally, we have recognition! Finally! I mean, I knew we had it in Expanded Universe, but none at all film-wise.
I think what's great is it's got the essence of 4, 5 and 6.
Yes.
But it's got the added bonus that it's going to look very up-to-date, it's going to be very fast. Mm. Modern filmmaking techniques.
Oh,
like a hybrid.
It's gonna be beautiful. I'm gonna cry. God help whoever's gonna come to the cinema with me and watch it. Just be
I'm gonna go see it multiple times. I'll go and see it with you.
I have not seen it. Not seen films like more than once in the cinema. That one, I will.
Definitely.
Definitely. That's just, it's a thing that's gonna happen. And oh, classic car. See? Look how beautiful that is compared to the other dirt. that's in there. Look at that. Oh, and it's red. I don't know what it is, but it's red and I like it.
And if you go missing from this car park, we'll know who to come and look for.
Yes. Oh, it makes me so happy. Oh, stop. Ticket. I was going to say, I don't know which platform the train's on, but then I realised you've only got the one platform. Even my train station's got two. This really is...
Service to London Marylebone.
That's me.
Calling at Aylesbury, Stoke Mandeville, Wendover, Great Missenden, Amersham, Chalfont and Latimer, Chorleywood...
All these names I've never heard of before, apart from London Marylebone.
And London Marylebone.
It's not Marylebone, it's Marylebone. Who says Marylebone?
He does.
It's Marylebone. Innit?
Innit, bruv.
Innit. Marylebone. Don't let the train take off without me, I'm coming. That's gonna suck a vicious sight. Yeah, I'm here, but the train's gonna leave.
That's the worst thing in the world.
Don't. It's like I was so close this morning. I was literally up on the platform. And that was it.
Well, here we are.
Goodbye, Sebastian!
Goodbye, Liam.
Oh. I'll see you again. I'll text you when I get back home.
Oh yes, okay.
London Marylebone.
Oh, it's sad.
Please ensure that you refrain from using.
It went really quick today.
And turn all other electronic devices.
My next one will definitely make it.
Yes. When you come over to me, I'll introduce you to Mark, who will be watching this as well. I'll come get Seb to meet you because I know you want to. Yes. I'll leave you there. This train's empty. It's like a ghost town.
Just wait till you get to Aylesbury. We'll soon get busy then.
Oh, yeah. Right. You literally live nowhere.
That's how we like it.
Oh. I don't think... Oh. Oh, gosh. Goodbye! Sebastian! And thus ends my trip to the middle of nowhere to go see Seb. On the train back now. Gotta go all through London, stop at London Bridge, and there's always a huge delay at London Bridge for a train to go back to mine. So food shall be had. Then we go home, go to bed, and then start the week anew. Okay, so thank you guys for watching this little vlog, and I will see you all in the next one.